Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Ensign Cthulhu here. This is a battle in my Tier 7 US battleship Colorado. Colorado is a very slow battleship. I've already worked past her, and for this reason, the captain that's in her now only has 3 skill points. Which I've applied to priority target, which lets me know how many people are looking at me with evil intent, and expert marksman to help the turrets turn a little bit faster. The important thing with these slow American battleships between tiers 3 and 7 essentially is to make sure that you are in the place to do the most possible good. And this is especially important when you're in a 20-knot ship like the Colorado, and the enemies you can face can do anything up to 40. You can't get anywhere quickly. You can't get out of there quickly if you get trapped, and so you have to make your decisions appropriately. This is a game in which things do not end well for me, but you'll see what it means for the team later. We begin, we can watch the enemy deploying, and I take my first shots at long range. And it looks like a miss. The other thing about battleships is that they only reload once every 30 seconds or so. So you want to try to make all your shots count. There's a destroyer coming into this capture point. I want to take a shot at him to see if I can whittle him down. On the other hand, it's important to not waste too much time shooting at ships you can't hit. I have to be very careful of this destroyer because he could come across that cap circle, cut me off and torpedo me, and there'd be very little I could do about it. Someone's shooting over the island there to set me on fire. Probably that New Orleans. Let's take a shot at him. And just over. This enemy battleship here is turning in, and he's going to offer me a valuable target for the next little while. At this long range, I'm hoping that some of my shells will go down through his deck armor into his vitals and citadel him, which would take a whole lot off his health that would be difficult to repair. Unfortunately, it's not working out that way. German battleships in particular are very resistant to this, and this one's no exception. In retrospect, I probably should have turned away from armor-piercing shells and tried high explosive to set some fires. But I was stubborn and foolish, and so I present this game so that you can learn from my mistakes and maybe make the other decision in these circumstances. You'll notice that I'm on fire, but I'm not repairing it with the R key because I don't want that to be on cooldown and unable to act if he sets me on fire again. All fire damage is repairable with the heal key. or T in this case. And it's better to let one fire burn. Now, that green ribbon there, defended, means that he was in the capture point and I hit him and reset his capture progress. Scoring these defense ribbons can earn you a lot of XP at the end of the battle. And it also keeps the enemy from taking the point. If I'd gone on my merry way and done something else, he might have it by now. So even if I'm not damaging him very much, resetting his capture progress is a valuable and important thing to do. Enemy aircraft coming in, I hit the tilde key to focus my anti-aircraft in on him. I've decided that it's now time to move because he's getting close enough to that landmass that I can't reliably hit him anymore. And if I stay here, I'm just going to become a punching bag, so it's time to move. Two fires on me. When you have two fires, it's really time to think about repairing. But I'm going to hold off for a bit while these rocket fighters are flying over and might set me on fire again. After they're shot down, I can repair more safely. Here's a very thin-skinned enemy cruiser coming along. Just three or four hits in the right place can do a lot of damage to them, so they're a valuable priority target. Going behind the landmass here means they can't shoot at me for a bit. I get a valuable respite while my health repair is on cooldown. Take another shot at the battleship. Unfortunately, in the time it took me to go behind the island, they've taken the sea capture point. But me holding them up there has enabled my team to dominate in the south and get some valuable capture points and also points for killing enemy ships. There you saw the terrain indicator, the mountain indicator, which told me that my shots were going to be blocked. Take a shot at this cruiser. Now here I've run into the map border, and that cuts my engine power down to half. It does make me a little harder to hit, but if they get in close and find a vulnerable spot, it's a lot harder to get out of this than any other situation. My team has actually been playing well here. They've killed a lot more of them than they have of us. And right now the best thing I can do is just continue to be an absolute pain in the backside up here. I could go for the New Orleans, or I could go for the far easier shot on this Budyonny. Take a shot. Focus my AA, and there's the kill with a Citadel hit into the machinery spaces. Enemy torpedoes coming in here. Fortunately, I don't get flooded. Now, do you remember that destroyer I told you about a little bit earlier? Well, he hung around. And he's just about to do me in. However, my whole team has now taken the A point, is crowding into the B point in the middle of the map. And even though I am thoroughly doomed, could have shot a little bit better there. Even though I am thoroughly doomed, my team's got this under control. Here come the torpedoes. I failed to get my bow around in time, and now I'm going to eat the whole lot. Warship destroyed by Mr. Clever 71. Well, he was clever, wasn't he? You can see here that my team is taking the middle capture point, and they're just going to charge en masse into Area C, take it, and kill everything. However, I sank a ship. I did nearly 40,000 points of damage. I soaked up 530,000 points of damage that might otherwise have been directed at other ships on my team, and I shot down 12 aircraft. I kept them busy in C and stopped them from moving down and taking care of my team, perhaps focusing them while they were still crowding through narrow choke points. And this is proof that even if you don't have a high point captain, you can still do good work and help the team to win. That's all. Thanks. Good night.